I think we're working now. Awesome, awesome. Okay. Welcome to Hollywood Revue with yours truly, Denise Harris. So I'm going to put some music on from the movies and do my sharing and posting, and we'll be right back with the top 10.
so unusual in your eyes. I know I'm home. Yeah. Every tear, every fear, gone with the thought of you changing what I thought I'd do. I'll be yours for a thousand lives. I'm freezing, but when I'm flying. Been waiting for a lifetime for you. Been breaking for a lifetime for you. Wasn't looking for love till I found you. Hold the night for love till I found you.
Skin to skin, breathe me in. Feel your kiss on your lips. I'm made of ecstasy. I'll be yours.
Get it started. The top 10 movies from last week, starting last Friday night through this past Thursday. Number 10 this week is Spies in Disguise. Yes, we all know about that one, right? 75% tomato meter, of course. 91% of the audience loved it. And the critics say a cheerfully undemanding animated adventure that's elevated by its voice cast. It's funny, fast-paced, and family-friendly. There you go. And of course, it's about super spy Lance Sterling and scientist Walter Beckett, who are almost the exact opposites. Lance is smooth, suave, and debonair. Walter is not. But when events take an unexpected turn, this unlikely duo is forced to team up for the ultimate mission that will require an almost impossible disguise, transforming Lance into the brave, fierce, majestic pigeon. Walter and Lance suddenly have to work as a team, or the whole world is in peril. We have Will Smith as Lance, Tom Holland as Walter, Rashida Jones as Marcy, Reba McEntire as Joyless. So, decent cast. Good kids movie. I might be seeing a movie this weekend or Monday. Because of the weather, I hope everybody's safe out there, by the way. Okay, number 9 this week, which is odd because it's been up there, but it's still in the top 10. You gotta love it. Let me see here. Okay. All right. Is Knives Out. So, you go Knives Out. Yes, absolutely. I highly recommend this movie to everybody. 97% tomato meter. 93% audience. So, what does that tell you, huh? The critics say it, Knives Out sharpens old murder mystery tropes with a keenly assembled suspense outing that makes brilliant use of writer-director Rian Johnson's stellar ensemble. The cast is awesome in this one. And, of course, acclaimed, it pays tribute to mystery mastermind Agatha Christie, of course. A fun modern-day murder mystery where everyone is a suspect. When renowned crime novelist Harlan Thrombey is found dead at his estate just after his 85th birthday, the inquisitive and debonair detective Benoit Blanc is mysteriously enlisted to investigate. From his dysfunctional family to its devoted staff, Blanc sifts through a web of red herrings and self-serving lies to uncover the truth behind Harlan's untimely death. It's a witty and stylish whodunit guaranteed to keep audience guessing until the very end. And, of course, the cast is spectacular. It's awesome. Daniel Craig as Benoit Blanc. Chris Evans as Ransom. Jamie Lee Curtis as Linda Robinson. Michael Shannon, Don Johnson. Toni Collette. She is hilarious. Catherine Langford. Frank Oz, yes. Christopher Plummer. So, totally star cast there, totally. So, there you go. Knives Out is number 9 this week. Number 8, surprise, surprise, right? Frozen 2. Okay. 70% tomato meter, 92% of the audience loved it. I know the kids were absolutely waiting for this one. And the critics say Frozen 2 can't quite recapture the show-stopping feel of its predecessor, but it remains a dazzling adventure into the unknown. So, and of course, you know, why was Elsa born with magic powers? The answer is calling her and threatening her kingdom. Together with Anna, Kristoff, Olaf, and Sven, she'll set out on a dangerous but remarkable journey. In Frozen, Elsa feared her powers were too much for the world. In Frozen 2, she must hope they're enough. Of course, Kristen Bell as Anna, Idina Menzel as Elsa, Josh Gad as Olaf, Jonathan Groff as Kristoff, Sterling K. Brown as Lieutenant Matthias, and Evan Rachel Wood as Queen Anuna. Frozen 2. Number 8. Number 7. I think people are just going to see this. It's not really, the audience didn't care for it either. Underwater. 50% tomato meter. Only 61% of the audience. I don't know. Critics say Underwater's strong cast and stylish direction aren't enough to distract from the strong sense of deja vu provoked by this claustrophobic thriller's derivative story. Okay, and this is about a crew of underwater researchers must scramble to safety after an earthquake devastates their subterranean laboratory. Okay, Kristen Stewart as Nora Price, Vincent Castle as the captain, John Gallagher Jr., Gunnar Wright, And y'all know how I feel about Kristen Stewart, right? Not a good thing. I'm not a fan of her at all. This is just my opinion, guys. It doesn't reflect the Spreaker or KBLP LLC's opinion. I just don't like her. She has no emotion. It's just like, I don't know. Might as well talk to a wall. But anyway, it is number 7 this week. I think it's going to drop next week, though. We shall see. Number 6 this week, Little Women. Another kind of fresh twist on the story. 95% tomato meter, 92% of the audience likes it. Critics say with a stellar cast and smart, sensitive retelling of the classic source material, Little Women proves some stories truly are timeless. And of course, we know what this is all about, right? The March Sisters. It unfolds the author's alter ego, Jo March, and reflects back and forth on her fictional life. In Gerwig's take, the beloved story of the March Sisters, four young women, each determined to live life on her own terms, is both timeless and timely. So, we all know what that's about, right? Saoirse Ronan as Jo, Emma Watson as Meg, Florence Pugh as Amy, Laura Dern as Marmy March. So there you go, Little Women. Timeless classic, of course. Number 5, Just Mercy. I've seen many trailers on this and stuff, and it looks really, really good. So, 84% tomato meter. Now listen to this one, 99% of the audience loved it. Woo, about 5,000 people, so there you go. The critics say it dramatizes a real-life injustice with solid performances, a steady directorial hand, and enough urgency to overcome a certain degree of earnest advocacy. And this is about... It's a powerful and thought-provoking true story. It follows young lawyer Brian Stevenson and his history-making battle for justice. After graduating from Harvard, Brian had his pick of lucrative jobs. Instead, he heads to Alabama to defend those wrongly condemned or who are not afforded proper representation with the support of local advocate Eva Ansley. One of his first and most incendiary cases is that of Walter McMillan, who in 1987 was sentenced to die for the notorious murder of an 18-year-old girl, despite a preponderance of evidence proving his innocence and the fact that the only testimony against him came from a criminal with a motive to lie. In the years that follow, Brian becomes embroiled in a labyrinth of legal and political maneuverings and overt and unabashed racism as he fights for Walter and others like him, with the odds in the system stacked against them. So, Just Mercy. Michael B. Jordan is Brian Stevenson. Jamie Foxx is Walter McMillan. Brie Larson as Eva Ansley. Rob Morgan. Tim Blythe Nelson. So, Just Mercy. It really looked good. So, just saying, might be one to see if you don't have anything going on this weekend. Excuse me. Number 4 is Like a Boss. I don't know how that ended up number 4, but okay. I think these numbers are going to change next week for sure. 19% tomato meter. Ouch. Only 66% of the audience liked it. The critics say, Like a Boss oversees a merger of powerful comedic talents, but the end results are likely to leave the audience members feeling swindled out of their investments. Ouch. Ooh. Savage. Okay. This is about best friends Mia and Mel. They are living their best lives, running their own cosmetics company they built from the ground up. Unfortunately, they're over their heads financially, and the prospect of a big buyout offer from a notorious titan of the cosmetics industry, Claire Luna, proves too tempting to pass up, putting Mel and Mia's lifelong friendship in jeopardy. So the beauty business is about to get ugly. We have Tiffany Haddish, Rose Byrne, Salma Hayek, and she plays Claire Luna, the one who takes over. Should be interesting. Billy Porter, Ari Grainer, like a boss. I don't know why it's number four, but the numbers, ooh, ouch, not good. Number three, here we go to the three. Jumanji, The Next Level, definitely on my list. Has anybody out there seen it? Let me know. Get in the chat and tell me. 71% tomato meter, 87% audience. So there you go. The critics say, like many classic games, Jumanji, Next Level, retains core components of what came before, while adding enough fresh bits to keep things playable. How can there not be with the cast? They were so awesome people in the first one. I love that movie. I really, really do. So good, so good. They were so great in that movie. In The Next Level, the gang is back. The game has changed. As they return to Jumanji to rescue one of their own, they discover that nothing is as they expect. The players will have to brave parts unknown and unexplored, from the arid deserts to the snowy mountains, in order to escape the world's most dangerous game. So, Jumanji, The Next Level, of course, Dwayne Johnson as Dr. Bravestone, Jack Black, Dr. Shelley Oberon, Kevin Hart as Mouse Finbar. The cast is just phenomenal. Karen Gillan as Ruby, Nick Jonas as Seaplane, Awkwafina as Ming. So there you go. Jumanji, The Next Level. Absolutely love the first movie I did. I thought it was great. Okay, number two. Of course, it dropped one from, it's been in number one for a couple of weeks to last week. Star Wars, The Rise of Skywalker. Okay, 52% tomato meter. Ouch, what is with these people? But 86% of the audience loved it. That's out of like 92,000 people, so that's damn good. The critics say Rise of Skywalker suffers from a frustrating lack of imagination, but concludes this beloved saga with fan-focused devotion. I have not seen it. Ooh, I know. Who out there has seen this movie? I want to know what you thought of it. I want to know what you all thought of it, okay? And of course, no one's ever really gone. Rey's journey continues and the Skywalker saga concludes in Star Wars, Rise of Skywalker. So there you go. Of course, we have Carrie Fisher, as Leia, so sad. Mark Hamill, Luke Skywalker, of course. Adam Driver as Kylo Ren. Daisy Ridley as Rey. Oscar Isaac as Poe Dameron. I don't know. I haven't seen this one. I'd really like to know what y'all thought of it. So, there you go. The number one movie, and this one is up for, you know, what, 11? It's got 11 Academy Award nominations. Of course, I'm talking about 1917. 89% tomato meter, 89% audience score. Critics say hard-hitting, immersive, and an impressive technical achievement. 1917 captures the trench warfare of World War I with raw, startling immediacy. And this is one. At the height of the First World War, two young British soldiers, Schofield and Blake, are given a seemingly impossible mission. In a race against time, they must cross enemy territory and deliver a message that will stop a deadly attack on hundreds of soldiers, Blake's own brother among them. George MacKay as Lance Corporal Schofield. Dean Charles Chapman as Lance Corporal Blake. Mark Strong as Captain Smith. Oh, he's so wonderful. Andrew Scott, Richard Madden. So there you go, 1917. And yes, it is up for, I think, 11. I think it's 11 nominations. And it also, 1970 outpaced Skywalker with 36.5 million wide opening. So, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, if you haven't seen that, see it. It is fantastic. I love Quentin Tarantino. He's just so twisted. I love him. And he leads the Critics' Choice Awards with 4 wins, including Best Picture. So, woohoo! Yeah. I gotta love that one. He's great. So, 1917 is the top movie of the week. We're gonna go to the top DVD and streaming. Which this should have come out already. Terminator Dark Fate should have come out this past Tuesday. Of course, Linda Hamilton Arnold is back. Parasite, Pain and Glory, 2050, which I have no clue. I've not heard of that. It's got Dean Cain in it, though. But Troop Zero and Give Me Liberty. Okay. Those are your new releases for the week. The top DVD. In streaming, of course, is Terminator Dark Fate again, Parasite, Pain and Glory, Countdown, The Lighthouse. That looked interesting. I think I'd like to see that just to see. Anybody seen that one, The Lighthouse? I'd like to see that one. I really would. So that's in your top DVD in streaming. Countdown, Lighthouse, Snatchers, Dark Encounter, okay, Maleficent, Mistress of Evil, of course, that's already out, but these are your top streaming and DVDs rented. Zombieland Double Tap, of course, oh yeah, I love that movie. Addams Family, of course, Gemini Man. I don't know if anybody's seen that one. I have not, but if it's on DVD, I'll see it or get it on demand. Joker, of course, up for, you know, a million Academy Awards in all categories. The Two Popes and Judy. So, those are your top DVDs and streaming. New releases, of course, those I just read them, Troop Zero, 2050, Parasite, and Terminator Dark Fate. Coming soon on DVD, Frozen 2, end of February, guys, Frozen 2, High Strung Free Dance, The Witch, Part 1. Oh, interesting, I'm going to see that, let me see. 85% tomato meter, 87% audience, what is that about? A young girl, Zhao Yun, lives with her after they found her alone in the woods and near death. When strange people start appearing in her life, she falls into turmoil as her seemingly ordinary life turns upside down in the blink of an eye. Okay, we'll go with that. The Witch, Part 1. Okay. Close Enemies. End of this month, Premature, next month, Kindness of Strangers, next month, Goldie, Serendipity, Come As You Are, Valentine's Day, After Midnight, First Love, of course, Jay and Silent Bob reboot, January 21st. The Climbers, and that's January 28th. So that's coming soon to DVD and streaming. Of course, Goldfinch is out on DVD. Highly recommend it, okay? Sounds good. All right. Let's go to what's open this weekend. Of course, Bad Boys for Life. Ooh, gotta love it, right? Will Smith, Martin Lawrence are back. I think I loved the first two. I really did. I thought they were really, really good. Doolittle, Robert Downey Jr. and Antonio Banderas. I would go see that just for fun. I really would. I love Robert Downey Jr. I love the trailers I've seen. So, I don't know. If you want something fun, that's the one I'd go see. My Hindu friend, The Host, that opened this week. Blood Widow, that opened, and I have no idea what that one's. Okay, let's find out. A serial killer is terrorizing Arizona with the police in hot pursuit. What the police don't know is that a mysterious ancient clandestine group is also pursuing the same killer. But to what end? From vampires to biblical wrath, everything comes down to one showdown. Oh, Blood Widow. You know, I'd probably see that on DVD. I don't think I'd go to the movies to see it, but I'd go see it. I'd see it. That opened this weekend. The Wave, Disturbing the Peace, Feedback. And that is about Jarvis Dolan is a star journalist of the successful London late-night radio show The Grim Reality. The evening takes a macabre turn when two armed men burst into the studio, taking control of the show. Their mission is to shed light on a scandal that could spell the end of Jarvis's established career. Forced to continue with the live program, following the script of the assailants, Jarvis Dolan's night will soon become a nightmare. Eddie Marson is Jarvis, Paul Anderson, Richard Brake. I don't know. Interesting. Okay. Interesting. So, that opened this week. Coming soon. Ooh. The Turning, of course, will be coming up a couple weeks, 24th. The Last Full Measure with Christopher Plummer. Sebastian Stan, The Turning, of course, and I think that's more like a remake, a new update on it, of The Innocents, if you remember, with Deborah Carr. The Gentleman with Matthew McConaughey. That says critics, Guy Ritchie, writer-director Guy Ritchie, many newcomers. Gentleman stands tall. Okay, let's see what this one's about. The Gentleman follows American expat Mickey Pearson, who built a highly profitable marijuana empire in London. When word gets out he's looking to cash out of the business forever, it triggers plot schemes, bribery, and blackmail in an attempt to steal his domain out from under him. And Matthew McConaughey, of course, Charlie Hunnam, Henry Golding, Michelle Dockery, Jeremy Strong, Eddie Marson. Okay. The Gentleman. Interesting. Gretel and Hansel. Now, this looked good. I'm not sure. This one is a long time ago in a distant fairy tale countryside. A young girl leads her little brother into a dark wood in desperate search of food and work, only to stumble upon a nexus of terrifying evil. Of course, I want to see that. Of course, it's horror. Of course. Excuse me. We shall see how that works out, though. So these are going to be opening within the next 2 to 3 weeks. Birds of Prey, of course, February 7th. Margot Robbie, Mary Elizabeth Winstead. This is a Birds of Prey. That should be pretty good. The Lodge. Richard Armitage. That should be good. Sonic the Hedgehog, The Kingsman, February 14th, Olympic Dreams, After Midnight, Call of the Wild, The Invisible Man. Now that I think would be interesting. Not to the end of February though. But we're going to, of course, every week we update, of course. And in March, coming up in March, this is, I think we've all been looking for this, The Quiet Place Part 2. So, The New Mutants will be coming out. Peter Rabbit 2, Cyborg, No Time to Die. And a new Trolls movie comes out in April. But of course, like every week I said, we update everything. So, we go through what's coming up, what's coming out. So interesting. Some good, decent movies out there. I haven't been too bad at all. Who's been watching The Deputy with Stephen Dorff? Oh my God, they're killing me already. If you haven't seen The Deputy, I highly recommend it. Thursday nights at 9 on Fox. That show, it's only the second one, and already that had me in tears. Totally crazy. So much stuff going on, but it's so, so good. Stephen Dorff, of course, is his wonderful, sarcastic self. I love him in this. It is great. Evil. If you have not seen Evil, Thursday nights at 10 after Deputy, you're missing out. I love, love Evil. It's great. you have to see it to believe. I absolutely love it. So if you haven't seen these shows, please do. I think you're missing out if you're not. And of course, everybody's watching The Witcher on Netflix. Oh my God, I love it. I absolutely love it. Totally insane, but I love it. I'm trying to see what else is. Of course, don't forget the conference games are on Sunday. I think it's 3:05 and 6:40. I think it's going to be the 49ers and Chiefs. That's what I think. We shall see. Now, remember, on Sports Talk, I asked you, give me your take on that. Let me know what you think. Okay. We have some crazy weather going on. We have a winter weather advisory out there. Please take it easy. You got it all. it's crazy. We're going to get a bunch of snow, sleet, freezing rain. It's going to be crazy. So please take care. A bunch of snow out west in the northern plains again, heading towards the east coast. But they're going to get a lot of rain over there. But PA, if you live in these areas, please take care. Good stuff, good stuff. Trying to think of what's going on. Okay, don't forget, in about half an hour, Freaks in the Basement will be on with our biggest freak of all, Chris Stevens. So don't miss that. Tomorrow, join me on Encounters of the Strange Kind. Can't wait. It's been a while. The holidays and just crazy stuff. So should be on tomorrow. Don't forget Sunday, of course, the conference. Monday, Michelle and I will be back with Planet B.O.B. Tuesday, I'll get on Sports Talk, discuss the games. Wednesday, the Book Corner. I'm going to discuss some Stephen King and, I think some Nora Roberts. Maybe not. We'll see. Haven't decided what I'm going to do, but in two weeks from, this next Wednesday, we're going to do Brian Lumley and the Necroscope series. Oh my God. If you haven't read that, it's sci-fi fan. It's great. Brian Lumley, Necroscope. So we're going to be discussing a lot of books. Trying to think what else is going on. That brings you up to date so far. Got a couple more songs for you. Then, stick around for Freaks in the Basement. Great, great music, alternative rock, hard rock, whatever. It's absolutely wonderful. He's got some great music, so tune in for that. That's it for me tonight. Go out, see some movies. Let me know what you think. Have a great weekend, y'all. Peace out.
Tell me what this is all about. I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone. But I ain't never crossed a man that didn't deserve it. Me be treated like a punk, you know that's unheard of. You better watch how you're talking and where you're walking, or you and your homies might be lying to chalk. I really hate the trip, but I gotta low. As they croak, I see myself in the pistol smoke. Fool, I'm the kind of cheater little homies wanna be like. On my knees in the night, saying prayers in the streetlight.
Been spending most of my life living in the desert.
Look at the situation they got me facing. I can't live a normal life. I was raised by the state, so I gotta be down with the hood team. Too much television watching got me chasing dreams. I'm an educated fool with money on my mind. Got my tin in my hand and a gleam in my eye. I'm a loped out gangster, set tripping banker. And my homies is down, so don't arouse my anger. Fool, death ain't nothing but a heartbeat away. I'm living life, do or die. What can I say? I'm 23 now, but will I live to see 24? The way things is going, I don't know. Minute after minute, hour after hour, everybody's running, but half of them ain't looking what's going on in the kitchen. But I don't know what's cooking. They say I got to learn, but nobody's here to teach me. If they can't understand it, how can they reach me? I guess they can't, I guess they won't, I guess they front. That's why I know my life is out of luck, fool.
Are you?
are you coming to the tree? They strung up a man, they say, who murdered three. Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where a dead man called out for his love to flee? Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where I told you to run so we'd both be free? Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where a necklace of hope side by side with me? Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where I told you to run so we'd both be free? Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree? They strung up a man, they say we murdered three. Strange things have happened to you, stranger would it be? We met.